In the world of heat transfer, you will encounter the term volumetric source or volumetric heat generation. In this video, you will learn about the same. While solving heat transfer problems, you will encounter situations where the system is being heated. For example, inside an internal combustion engine, combustion takes place because of combustion heat is released inside the entire combustion chamber, which looks like a cylinder, right? This is what we refer to as heat source or volumetric heat generation, or sometimes simply energy source. Volumetric heat source is the energy released in unit volume at a given second. So the unit is going to be joules per meter cube second. Joule per second is watts, and hence volumetric heat generation is commonly written with the units of watt per meter cube. Volumetric source is commonly encountered while performing energy balance. Let us consider a rectangular plate. Let Q be the quantity of heat that comes in, and we are going to assume that Q is equal to 10 watts. The top and bottom walls of the rectangular plate are adiabatic. That is, there is no heat transfer taking place in both these directions. Now, if we say that there is a volumetric heat generation of 10 watts per meter cube, then what is the energy that actually goes out of the plate? The answer is quite simple. The area of the rectangle is, let's assume, 1 meter square, and its thickness is 0.5. Hence, the volume of this entire plate is 0.5 meter cubes. So if you multiply the heat generated with the volume, you get 5 watts. So in other words, the total heat that actually goes out is going to be 15 watts. Now, when you're doing an energy balance, make sure that all the terms in that equation have the same units. All right. I hope you learned about volumetric source in this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.